I'm going to learn how to draw and paint PUBG. So media which I'm going to use here is a poster of color on a paper. So right now I'm just drawing the outline. Remember, when you draw your outline, make it sure that the proportion of the initially in the beginning you might have seen there is a pumpkin along with a slice. So slice was the first thing which I chose to draw, and then after drawing slice, I chose to draw the rest of the part of the pumpkin. Actually, in this nature drawing, I have kept knife also, which was creating interest in the drawing. And while arranging the composition, I got the interest by taking out the seeds and spreading around the pumpkin. You can also do the same thing, can bring the interest into the composition. So let's start the painting now. I took a chrome yellow, yellow ochre, lemon yellow, these colors. This is my usual practice and recommendation that foreground and background coloring can be done initially to reduce the pressure of the coloring the paper area and time management. So right now I'm coloring the background and foreground. So color which I have taken in, they are like chrome yellow, yellow ochre, you can see background is done. Now foreground is I'm coloring. So although knife I had drawn initially, but the knife I'm overlapping in my paint right now. Later on I'm going to show that knife part plus the seeds part. So right now just a little bit depth I have created between the horizon line and the foreground. Now after coloring, and yes, after coloring I am deliberately overlapping the outline, because later on these overlapping techniques are going to help me to create the natural effect. So when you paint, make sure the entire, now you can see entire area is done in a chrome yellow. Almost the intensity of the chrome yellow is more. And now I took a partial view, ultramarine view, and then after taking these two shades, a little bit yellow ochre I added, and now slice, which is kept in front of the entire composition that I am painting right now with a small round brush, approximately number size is a 4 to 5, which you can take. The surface was very tricky here, and for me the challenging part was like make out exactly what shade should I mix, and this is going to come to you also. So ask yourself, keep observing continuously. Certain areas after applying the color I was not satisfied with the shade, so I recreated, reapplied, and this may happen with you also, but don't worry, you have to keep on reapplying the shade until and unless you don't come across with the desired shade. You are going to do these all experiments, and that's what the objective of the still life and nature is, to develop the ability of observation is the main objective behind the nature and the still life 2020. So right now again yellow ochre tone and chrome yellow and little bit touch of orange. So these colors I have taken along with the Persian blue little bit and little bit ultramarine blue. Now after coloring the dark, deep side, darker side, I am coloring to the light side. Now this is my way of drawing and painting, that I develop the picture from the deep tone to light tone, but then it's not, there is no compulsory and there is no rule that you also should do the same way. You have your own liberty. You can start painting from the light to dark and achieve the result. I select traveling from dark to light, so that is what I have developed my style of painting. You can also develop your own style of painting from which side you wish to travel, that you should be practicing from the beginning only, then only you should do that. And for that purpose, the recommendation is that in the beginning only you should decide like, okay, this is the way of my drawing and painting. This is the style which I want to develop. Now you can see actually there are many detailings inside the slice. If you go back to the video and if you see the slice and the inside part of the pumpkin, it was so much tricky and so much confusing that exactly what shade should I pick up, exactly from where should I start, these all questions were continuously popping up in the mind. But believe me, you just have to fill up the tone initially. Don't go into the depth initially. Just see where the light tone, put up the light, where is the middle tone, put up the middle, where is the light dark tone, put up the dark, and that's it. Now again, same thing by holding a brush, round brush in a hand and just dragging it on a light and middle tone. You can see now a light tone is filled up, little bit middle tone is also seen. And here again, I'm the surface now. This surface was like very much tricky again here. If you go back to the video and see, the skin was like completed with the Persian view and ultramarine view, and plus on that sharp light was continuously falling. So for me to show the dotted texture, it was like a stippling method technique, I can say. I had to use somewhere, and later on I merged the technique also because I don't wanted the technique to go all over, because if I do that, then the picture will look monotonous. So to avoid that monotonousness, what I did, I simply kept stippling method somewhere, and then later on, now you can see I am merging the border, merging the outline in the background. And while merging the outline in the background, I am not thinking at all whether I am maintaining my outline or not. I am just simply merging it because I want to do that deliberately, because to bring the natural effect. You can see now, it is just like an abstract painting. You can see, you would wonder that what are you doing? You are just breaking the outline. Yes, I am breaking the outline because I want to achieve the result. That is a natural result, and that result can be achieved with this technique. So when it comes to you can also merge your outline into the background somewhere, so it creates a natural effect. Now you can see I have shown the shadow also of the pumpkin and slice, and now adding more and more details. Palette is also in front of you for the reference. So you can see now, right now I am coloring this sliced area of the pumpkin. So that is more usually done in a yellow ochre, than chrome yellow, than the a bit touch of orange and bit touch of burnt sienna. These all colors I have taken inside right now while painting, and moving brush all over the picture wherever there is a light, adding white wherever there is a deep tone, not black, but taking the Persian view and ultramarine view. So these techniques I am using right now, and now coloring the stem. So stem was a little bit again more of yellow ochre and less of chrome yellow or less of blue. And here is more of the yellow ochre and then adding white. Here also on the stem also I have shown the light tone and the middle tone and the dark tone. After all, stem also is a very much important part of this entire composition. It shows how heaviness of the pumpkin is. And right now I am giving the more deep tone and dark touches to the pumpkin to bring more natural effect. And here you can see much better idea of the pumpkin you will get now. Still I am not satisfied with the outer part, so outer part again I am going to deal with the Persian blue, ultramarine blue and white. So applying the same tone again, now you can see I am applying light tone actually here in this angle, on this area actually light was falling. So this area I had to deal with a very much minor details. I had to cover this area to bring more natural effect and realistic effect, and to maintain the beauty and maintain the originality of the picture, the exactness of the pumpkin. There is very much minute dark tone, like a stippling method, as I mentioned initially. So the stippling method I am going to show now after applying the light tone. So right now I have applied the light tone, and now again I will take the deep tone, that is ultramarine view and Persian view, and then I am going to show the stippling. But at the same time I will make it sure that it should not create any hard impact. Hard impact in the sense, when you look at the picture, it should look very much soft. It should look elegant. So that feel also I had to maintain. So gradually for journey from the light tone to dark tone here on the skin, you will find now stippling method, and you can see now stippling method is done. Again I was merging it. Again stippling method. Again I was merging. Again stippling method. Again I was merging. It was like that. So same way you have to do it in use the technique. This light was actually on the other side also. So other side also I am putting up the light. Now you can see here the color application on the outer part of the pumpkin is going on, and stippling method kind of thing I am right now dealing with. This is, you can say, is almost like a stippling method. Again, stippling method. again deep tone I have taken. It's Persian blue, ultramarine blue, and now I'm doing the stippling method. For this purpose, you need to go to close to the object and you have to observe. I was doing the stippling method again, I was merging it. Now you can see outer part is almost looking very similar to the result. Now I'm putting a highlight on a pumpkin. White tone is added more. More light tone here. And now bring up more details with a small size brush on this theme. On this theme also I'm putting all the detailings like, you know, light tone, middle tone, dark tone, reflection tone, reflection tone. So here main thing is like you have to keep paying attention on the shades and lights. Now you can see I am creating the shades in a such a way. Yes, keep cleaning your palette continuously. This is going to help you a lot. This is the interconnected, dear students, that continuously keep cleaning your brushes, your palette. This really reflects in your work. So please do not underestimate this part, that ignoring the cleanliness of the palette, ignoring the wellness of the brush. Good quality brushes and clean palette is going to give good result along with a good quality of colors. The good quality of the colors means what? They should not be dry, and yes, they should not be too much watery also when it comes to post color. You can see now it's like I'm putting up the more detail on the pumpkin, and we are close to the finishing touches now. We are very much close to the finishing now. I'm just giving the finishing touches, holding small brush in my hand. This is like outer part of this slice. There also light was falling. Actually, interesting part I want to tell you here is like when I sat in front of the pumpkin on the first day, it was very much fresh. On the second day, it was not that fresh. So what suggestion here is for you, that whenever you sit for the work, whenever you do the work, make it sure that you do the work in one sitting only. Like on the first day I sat for 1.5 hour, and on the second day I sat for 1.5 hour, and in one sitting I was not able to complete. So now what I'm doing right now is just inner part of the slice, which I told you, like, which was like a braid. It was like a braid. So those detailing I am adding right now. So again, creating the shade. Now this is very much we are going towards the finishing. So I am taking the small brush in my hand. Same thing, observe what is in front of you. Try to create the shade, apply the shade. It's just ongoing process. Then only you will come across with a good result of the any of, not only this picture, but any of the picture. Like, I was continuously looking at it, was not satisfied with the results, so again I was recreating the shades. So from this process you have to go, there is no other alternative. And yes, do not make any haste to complete the picture. Gradually you have to develop, gradually you will develop the picture. Now what I'm doing, I'm developing the picture gradually. Same way, right now, what I'm doing right now, there is adding details to the pumpkin. Highlighted area is more. And trying to decrease and increase, trying to maintain the intensity of the color rather. I won't say decreasing or increasing, I am just maintaining the beauty of the tonal value. Now, again, looking at the object and continuously asking myself, is it, like, which area of the pumpkin should I complete right now to bring more perfection? So, I chose to complete the shadow and background part once again. Shadow and background and foreground, please do not underestimate this area. Don't think that they are not a part of the picture. Actually, that is also a very much important part of the picture. You cannot underestimate those areas. See, now I'm just applying tone everywhere, like background also, foreground also, and shadow also. You can see shadow once again I have shown. And folds right now I am just putting up inside the shadow. On this area I have played for a long time. You see more shadows reflected, and background again I am decreasing. the intensity was too much light, so I'm putting it dark or deeper in the background. Why I'm doing this? So my foreground and my object, it comes out of the background. Use adequate water. It should not be too much watery also. Actually, after some time you'll find the paper is turning. It is bent. So this is what overall output is right now. Again, I'm going to put more and more deep tone on the background. You can see right now I'm working on the horizon line and showing more deep tone on the where showing more shadow. Shadow, as I told you, you cannot underestimate that area. You can see more deep tone is brought into the background and the shadow. So my and here I'm what I'm doing right now, this knife, which initially I had wiped out white coloring. So right now I'm showing knife. Although I did directly the brush, but in your case you can take the pencil and then first create the outline, then draw and paint. Although I did it directly, but you don't do this experiment. Again, I'm doing the same thing. Here showing the inside part, as I told you, like inner part was very tricky. And putting more detailing on the both the sides, light tone also and dark tone also. Now on the knife, various texture was taking place, like backside there was a cloth which was in cadmium yellow, and again that cadmium yellow was falling onto the on the metal of the knife. And here there are seeds. I have taken a bit fast forward here just to save on the time. So more shadow I showed, and then again backside I just have taken the background to the more deep tone and working on the shadow once again. Putting up more detailing. Actually, when you go close to the finishing, you'll notice, you'll realize that you'll find there is always scope for the improvement. Okay, now here you can see I am putting more and more water on the background and I am making background more deep. Now background is no more in a chrome yellow, it's almost a yellow ochre and dark black color and Persian blue and ultramarine blue. And few effect of the folds I am trying to create. And you can see now more realistic touch has come. Now knife, seeds and pumpkin, entire picture is ready. Entire work is ready.
can see now almost picture is like getting complete, and proper touches of the dark tone is done. Here is the entire picture. You can have a look.